completeness, instruction set completeness. If you want to execute an instruction internally, so many operations should be performed. So the operations are like you have to complete the functions, functional requirements, that is arithmetic operations or logic operations, shift operations, etc. Next, coming to the next one, if data is there from one location to another location, you need to transfer. Next one, control operations. Control instruction should be executed. Next, input-output instructions should be executed. That means if you want to execute an instruction internally, so many functions should be performed. So a computer should have a set of instructions so that the user can construct machine language programs to evaluate any function that is known to be computable. That means if you want to execute a task, so what are the instructions are required to execute that particular task? All those instructions should be available with the computer. So in that manner, you will have the instruction types like functional instructions. First one is the functional instructions. Second one, transfer instructions, control instructions, and IO instructions. Okay. Functional instructions, transfer instructions, control instructions, and IO instructions. Coming to the first one, functional instructions, you will have the arithmetic operations, logic, and shift operations. Examples, add. Next one, complement, accumulator, increment, CIR, okay, circular right, circular left, AND operation, and clear accumulator. These are related to the functions, okay, to perform a function. Next, coming to the transfer instructions, the data transfers between main memory and the processor registers. Anyone, can you tell me how many processor registers are there in a basic computer? Yes, ma'am. How many registers are there? Processor registers. Already we discussed in the last class. I'm asking about the registers. Anvita? Anvita, are you there? Yes, ma. Yes.
Wait.
8 registers, good. So 8 registers, so the data transfer can be between the main memory and all these 8 processor registers. So for that you require transfer instructions. Okay, load accumulator, store accumulator, these are the instructions related to the processor register called accumulator. Load accumulator means what we are doing. We are transferring the contents. We are transferring the contents to the accumulator. Store accumulator means whatever the data is there present in the accumulator, that will be stored into the memory. Next one, control register. So for the control operations, you are having the program sequencing and control. So to sequence the operations, that means first instruction should be executed. Next, it should be moved on to the next second instruction. Again, third instruction. After third instruction, if you have any condition checking, okay, you need to check for that condition. If the condition is true, next instruction should be executed. If the condition is false, it will go for the next skip operation or else part. Okay, that will be done with the help of control instructions. So BUN represents branch unconditionally without any condition, that is just simple jump statement. Okay, jump. Next, branch. Branch if skip a equal to 0. Next one, ISZ if skip equal to 0. So these are the simple examples of control instructions. Next one, input output instruction. For transferring of the data between the input and output devices and the processor, you require input output operations. That means a complete task will be executed if you have all these type of instructions internally with a computer. Otherwise, it is not possible to compute the particular task. Next, the next topic is about the control unit, which is which plays an important role in a computer. Okay, so control unit controls all the operations related to the processor, related to the computer. So control unit of a processor translate from machine instructions to the control signals for the micro operations that implement them. Okay, that means here what it is doing, the control unit is a part of the computer which controls all the operation there by translating the machine instructions into the control signals. Okay, signals will be forwarded to the internal parts with the help of control unit only. Based on those signals only the operations will be done. The control units are implemented in one of the two ways. Those are hardwired control. First one is hardwired control and second one is microprogrammed control. Coming to the first one, hardwired control, the control unit is made up of sequential and combinational circuits to generate the control signals. Okay, what we discussed in DLD, combinational circuits and sequential circuit, those will be helpful for preparation of the fire construction of the hardwired control unit. Coming to the microprogrammed control unit. So the microprogrammed control unit will have the control memory on the processor, which contains the microprograms, that activate the necessary control signals. That means, what is the difference between hardwired control and microprogrammed control? Means the hardwired control procedure, the circuit, hardwired control procedure, you will have the control signals with the help of sequential and combinational circuits. Whereas in microprogrammed control, the control signals will be generated with the help of microprograms. Now, what is microprogram? It is a set of micro instructions. Okay, So, whenever you want to execute an operation, for that particular instruction, some microprogram will be written internally in the control memory. So, control memory will be executed and the signals will be released. Signals will be enabled for applying that particular operation, for executing that particular task. So there, these are the major types of control units, hardwired control and microprogrammed control. In the hardwired control, you can generate the control signals. Whereas in the micro, generate signals with the help of sequential and combinational circuits. But coming to the microprogrammed control, you have the microprograms to generate the control signals. Next, we will consider a hardwired implementation of the control unit for the basic computer in this manner. So this is the timing and control diagram, the control unit of the basic control unit. Okay. So, what is the operation of control unit? We will discuss in this diagram, okay, in detail. So, here the instruction register is there. In the instruction register, you have the 16-bit length, 16-bit length instruction is stored. Yes, ma'am. Someone raised a hand. Why? Yes? Okay. So, here the instruction register consists of the instruction which is of 16-bit length. out of that first 12 bits are address. Okay, this is the basic instruction format. Next 3 bits are opcode. Next 3 bits are opcode. I represents 15th bit represents I, that is shown here. Okay, that is shown here. Now, so if you want to, if the system want to execute any task, first it should be decoded. First it should be decoded. So for that purpose, we are using a decoder. We are using a decoder. So it should decode the operation code, opcode. So opcode, how many bits are there here? For the opcode, 3 bits are there. 3 bits. If there are 3 inputs for a decoder, how many outputs will be generated? Yes. How many outputs will be generated?
8.
So 3x8 decoder is required. So the same decoder is taken here, 3x8, and 3 inputs, 8 outputs. 3 inputs and 8 outputs. Next. So, what are the outputs here? 0, 1, 2, 3, up to how many, ma? 7. 0 to 7. It is shown in the decoder output, and these outputs are forwarded to the combinational control logic. Okay? Combinational control logic. Next. What is this I represents? I value is either 0 or 1, that is also forwarded as the input to the control logic. Next, here the output is, decoder output is 8 bits, but wherever you see coming to the i value equal to 0, how many memory reference instructions are there? Count it once. How many memory reference instructions are there? If you see this, you will understand. 0 to? Yes, ma. How many are there? 0 to 6. 0 to 6. But if it is indirect, again you are having 8 to E. That is again here also 6 operations only. What about 7th output here? 0 to 6 is present for all the operations, 0 to 6. What about the 7th bit? Anyone? When it will be active? Ma? In case of register or IO. Because in register or IO, you will have the opcode value as 111, right? So, what is this first bit? 7. 7. If D7 means 111. 111 will be active either in case of 0111 or 1111. This is 7. This is also consisting of 7. Okay? So D7 will be used for differentiating the register reference or IO. Register reference or IO. So if it is up to 6, then you can simply say that it is a memory reference instruction. So the decoding operation will be done with the help of control unit. Okay, in the control unit, we are using the 3x8 decoder to decode the opcode. What is the length of the opcode? 3 bits. Output will be 8 bits. So 3x8 decoder is used. But out of 8 bits, if you go with the memory reference instruction, you will have the outputs as only 0 to 6. Only 0 to 6. What about 7th bit? When it will be active means in case of either IO or register reference. In this way, It will identify to go for memory or register, register or IO operations. Okay, the entire thing will be done with the help of decoder and internal control. It will be passed to the control logic. In the control logic, it will, combinational control logic, it will identify whether to move to the memory or register or IO devices to extract the data. Next, all these things will be done. All these things will be done in the time gap T0 to 215. T0 to T15. So here for that we are using the 4-bit sequence counter. In the 4-bit sequence counter, 4 inputs will be given and 16 outputs will be produced. 16 outputs will be produced. So the time taken for the computer, basic computer, to execute a particular task, it will require 15 clock cycles. 15 clock cycles. So to T0 to T15. T0 to T15. So totally 16 outputs will be there. All these 16 outputs will be connected to combinational control logic. Next, why we are using sequence counter here? Sequence counter. What is mean by a counter? For counting purpose. For counting purpose. So here it will be used to calculate the, it will be used to calculate the time signals produced by the control unit to execute a particular task. And here there are three inputs given. One is clock, second one is clear, third one is increment. For any increment operation, INR will be supplied to the sequence counter. So from 0 it will be move on to 1, 1 to be 2, 2 to 3, like that it will be incremented by 1 by 1. Once after the completion of execution of that particular instruction, it will be clear to 0. SC value will be clear to 0. Okay, finally the control signals will be produced to execute the given task, that is to complete the instruction which is stored in the instruction register. Which is stored in the instruction register. This is about the control unit of basic computers. This is about control unit of basic computer. So without control unit, it is not possible to compute an instruction or possible to execute an instruction. So to know, to execute the particular instruction, first you should identify which type of instruction it is. That will be based on the decoder output. That will be based on the decoder output. So here 15th bit is taken as I. 15th bit is taken as I. If I equal to 0, if I equal to 0 and third line is active, third line is active. What it means? What it means, ma? Which type of instruction it is? I equal to 0, opcode is 011. Which type of instruction it is?
Direct
memory reference.
Very good, very good. Thank you. So it is of memory instruction of direct address. Okay, of direct address. Now, if it is I equal to 1, and opcode, that is D7, is active, then which type of instruction it will be? D7 is active and I value equal to 1. Which type of instruction it will be?
Input-output instruction.
Very good. Input-output instruction. In that manner, first it will identify which type of instruction. Based on that, if it is the reference instruction, if it is the memory reference instruction, then the control signal will be generated to search in the memory. To search in the memory. If I equal to 0, D7 is active, then it is of type register reference. If it is of register reference, the control signals will be generated to search in the registers. To search in the registers. In this way, it will identify the type of instructions, and based on that, the control signals will be released. Okay, will be enabled to execute that particular task. So this is the timing diagram which shows the T0, T1, T2, T3. Okay, this is the one clock cycle. Okay, this is one clock cycle here. T0 is active, and at the remaining time, T0 will be inactive mode. Okay, in the same manner, T1, T2, T3, T4. Next here, D3. That means to find that D3 is active. D3 means 0, 1, 1. That means after T4, after four clock cycles, the control unit is identified. Control unit identified that D3 is active. That is 0, 1, 1 is the opcode. Based on that, the next step will be taken. Okay, it is a simple example given. D3T4:SC20. Okay, assume that a time for SC is clear to 0 if decoder output is D3 is active. The same, D3 is active here. So after that, what happens? The entire thing will be cleared. Okay, that means the decode is open for the next execution. Decode is ready for the next execution. D3, T4 represents D3. D3 is the output of the decoder. T4 is the clock cycle, fourth clock cycle, SC is assigned to 0. SC is assigned to 0. That means sequence counter value will be 0 once after completion of this one. Once the D3 is identified, this is about the timing.